you may have those type of situations, but when it's God, and you know that you know, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, he speaks in several ways. I'm a dreamer. God speaks to me in dreams.
Yeah, it's another way.
God speaks to us through people. God speaks to us through his word.
Yeah.
God speaks to us through experiences, encounters. Right. And I think we have to notice many times God is speaking all day long.
Yeah.
But are we listening?
Right.
If I have headphones on right now and my wife is talking to me, I can't hear because my focus is listening to something else. Even though she's talking to me and saying something that may be extremely critical for my future and my well-being, I can't hear her if my ears are attentive to another sound.
Right.
And I think we have to become a people who are attentive to the sound of heaven so that we won't embrace the chaos of hell. Be attentive to the sound of heaven so we won't embrace the chaos of hell. I want to make sure that this is heaven endorsed.
Right,
I want to make sure that God is behind me on this. And this is not something that's just relational. This could be about starting a ministry. You don't want to do something in haste. You want to know that you know that God called you. You never mistake when your phone rings. You only mistake it when you're not sure it rang. But when you see it ringing over and over, you have confirmation that somebody's calling me. You want to make sure that this calling that is on my heart to start a ministry, to launch something on campus, is not just me doing it, but there's something ringing in my spirit. There's something ringing in my being that's telling me I should do this. Confirming. Sometimes it's a tension. Sometimes that's your confirmation. Like this tension, like, I don't know if I should do this. I don't know if I should go over there. I don't know if we should go out. That's confirmation.
Sometimes it's not just confirmation for the good. It's confirmation that something that
to
will
caution you.
To caution you. Like, you get confirmation like you were gonna move forward, or you know, seem things may seem like it's all working together, but you have, like he said, that tension. Don't ignore that. That is God confirming. That is the Spirit confirming. This ain't it, like we said on the last one. So don't ignore that tension, because God, you need that confirmation, because this is your life that we're talking about. This is your you know, your purpose. This is, I mean, and this could, like we've said before, this could propel you or this could derail you. I mean, and you don't want to be thrown off track because you don't have that assurance in your spirit to know that this is I know that this is what God has for my life, and I'm gonna step out on faith and I'm gonna move forward because I've got that witness, either to move forward or to step away. You need that confirmation either way. And if you don't have that confirmation, don't move. Period. I mean, you don't want to, like, okay, well, I don't have the confirmation yet, so let me go ahead and make the move, and then you find out 5 years later that wasn't it. I would rather wait and then 5 years later say, okay, this is it. And then, okay, but you know what? I didn't miss nothing. Instead of going 5 years and then it's a mess, it's horrible, and your life is all, you know, derailed because you went without the confirmation. Okay? So it's better just to wait on God for that assurance and not move forward.
What's that Disney movie? Is it Moana? That's how it's pronounced?
Moana.
I was watching Moana, don't judge me. And there was a scene where she was about to quit. She was about to go back to her village because she couldn't give that lady her heart. And the grandmother came, like, in a spirit form. And she was about to go back, and she had her paddle in the water and was about to go back to the village. And the grandmother was like, "Why do you hesitate?" And Moana was like, "Man, I know that the water called me. I know that I'm supposed to be doing this, but it's just so hard right now." And she couldn't go back because she had a confirmation in her. She saw something in her before she ever launched out. And in the same way, when you do launch out, when you do get married, when you do have an opportunity, when you do become a parent, when you do things that God has blessed you to do, when you have that confirmation, if you ever want to quit, there's just this hesitation. Don't give up. Don't get a divorce. Don't quit. Keep preaching, keep singing, keep loving, keep giving, keep serving. Because you have you have that confirmation. Something has called you to this place. And you'll remember that calling in the midst of feeling weak.